So thanks. Welcome to my session. This is the top tips for Grow templates. Just getting used to this. My name is Tom Zion. I'm a director of product management here at Clio. I'm from Connecticut, but I currently live in the great state of Rhode Island. And so are there any other New Englanders in the house? You know, someone that's great. There's two of us, which is kind of like the whole state of Rhode Island, you know? I'm going to be walking through all of the different template types in Clio Grow. Clio Grow is our intake system. And what you can do is set up a lot of templates in there that'll help really automate some of the key workflows in your system. And I want to walk you through those and how you can take advantage of those today. Now, the first one that we're going to cover is document templates. And we have two different document template types in Clio Grow. The first one is our text editor template. It's our blank canvas. You can do whatever, you can do a lot with it. And it's the one that we most often recommend. And the second one is our PDF editor, which is better for more rigid use cases. And we'll show you why here in just a second. So our first one, text editor templates. The text editor template is your blank canvas. It's fully customizable. You could control the formatting, the alignment. You can include images and logos in there. And really what we encourage everyone to use these for are for your client engagement letters. You'll see that some of the fields on here are marked in yellow and in green. These are what we call merge fields, or it's a way for you to take information from your contact or matter data and inject it into the document. And then when you do that, we'll automatically pull it in per matter and spit it out into a format that you can use and continue to edit from there. Our second type is our PDF templates. These are purposefully rigid and they're best used for governmental forms or for certain documents that you need to maintain margins or you need to maintain a certain page structure. They're not used as often, but for those customers who like to use our forms to or use our temp or document automation to do PDF forms, we do recommend it. Again, if you want to have that strict file structure and that stiff, strict formatting type. And regardless of which one you use, we do recommend the use of our e-signature technology. Really, it works for both type of documents, and so we recommend it for either case. And this feature has really exploded in popularity over the past 2 years. Now, just to showcase that, what we did is we pulled one of the data points from a previous legal trends report, where 23% of people were open to remote options. That number has exploded recently. And in the 2019 legal trends report, what we saw is that 79% of consumers actually seek out remote options. So really, if you're not using this information today, you should start doing it. The e-signature, it's starting to be expected from consumers. Now, there's a lot of benefits. They can use it on the go. They can use it for all the different document types. So again, recommend that you use it regardless of the document template type that you use. The second template type that we want to cover are email templates. These are hopefully a little straightforward, but allows you to program different templates that you can use and send out from Clio Grow. Now, we have a lot of different template types that are oriented around the key workflow options that Grow has. You can create certain templates off of forms, documents, appointments, or if you just want to create generic email templates, you can do that too. You can use these if you want to nurture a cold lead. If there's a FAQ or something that you find yourself sending often, these are templates that you can set up in our system and then send out on demand. Now, within our email templates, you have similar customization options that you have in our text editor. You can control formatting, you could add images. If you really want to have different colors in your emails, you can do that too. All of these are options for you as you're setting up the email that you want to send out repeatedly to your prospective clients. These email templates are also offered in our email marketing campaigns as well. So you can, again, just further kind of uses and opportunities that you have when setting this up. And the last thing that at least within email templates that I wanted to selfishly share, call out, is our automatic appointment reminders. This is a new feature that my team worked on. And what this allows you to do is set up different email reminders to be sent out before or right after meetings are scheduled. What you can do is set up to five different types or five different time frequencies. And so if you want to set the email to go out 15 minutes before, 1 hour before, or 3 days before, this is something that you could do and control at a global level for all of your meetings. And if you want to override it on a matter per matter basis, you have that option as well too. The last template type that I want to cover are workflow templates. What you can do with workflow templates is really string all of this together. And we see all different types of firms get a lot of value out of this. Whether you're a sole practitioner, this will help you remember to do key tasks. Or if you're scaling your firm, what this allows you to do is make sure that you ensure consistent tasks and emails and different types of actions are completed for each client. And the way that they look is like this. You can set up these different things, you can apply it to a matter, and it gives you that consistency, that scalability, and really the better client experience and client experience for anybody who comes in your firm and making sure that it's consistent across all of them. So in summary, we covered a good chunk here in a real quick amount of time. We covered text editor templates, really your blank canvas that are fully customizable. I covered PDF templates, a more purposefully rigid template type for those court forms or more strict document formatting. I then called out e-signature, something that you should use for all document types. It's only growing in popularity. From there, I moved on to the different email templates and then the options that you have around automatic appointment reminders. And then we finished up with workflow templates, how you can string all of this together and set up a repeatable set of tasks to be done for each matter. Now, if you want to dig into any of these, please go visit us over in the product lab. We have a lot of people from the Clio Grow team there that can help walk through all of the different template types. And if not, and you're satisfied, I just want to say thank you. Appreciate you for taking the time, listening to me speak about templates. And afterwards, I'll be talking about tips with forms. So thank you very much.